Now we are going to start with the chapter, that is atoms and molecules. Now, as we see matter around us, there are lots and lots of matter in our surroundings, and every matter is made up of some basic structure. Now these basic structures are atoms and molecules. Okay, so there are some of the laws in favor of these atoms and molecules. So let's see about them. Laws of chemical combination. Now, laws of chemical combination states that there is a particular chemical combination because of which the atoms are stated. Okay, means there are two laws of chemical combination, and they are laws of conservation of mass and law of constant proportion. Now, what do we mean by law of conservation of mass? This means that if 1 kg of one amount of matter is mixed with 1 kg of another amount of matter, then their total will be having 3 gram of matter, 3 gram of matter, because 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. So the mass of the two matter is always equal to the mass that is obtained by mixing these two matter. So this is the basic idea of laws of conservation of mass, and if the mass increases or decreases, then these law will not be satisfied. Okay, then these pure chemical combination would not be satisfied. Then comes laws of constant proportion. This means that, for example, let's take water. Okay, so in water there is a particular proportion of hydrogen and oxygen. So in every molecule or in every element of water, we will be finding the same amount of proportion. So the proportion is constant in all the elements of the water. Okay, whether we pick water from here or from here, the ratio will be same. The proportion of the chemical combination will be same. So it is known as the law of constant proportion. Now Dalton was the scientist, and he gave out these laws, and because of which he gave out some of the postulates of Dalton's atomic theory, which was stated as postulates of Dalton's atomic theory. He stated that atoms are the indivisible particles which participate in chemical reactions. Atoms are the smallest particles. In his atomic theory, there were many drawbacks, but it just wanted to explain the laws of constant proportion. Then he stated that atoms of different elements have different chemical composition and different masses, and atoms of same elements have same chemical composition and same masses. He also stated that atom is the smallest particle which participates in the chemical reaction. And these were some of the Dalton's atomic law, postulates of Dalton's atomic theory. Then comes, what is an atom? Now, as we hear the word atom, we strike that what is atom exactly? What atom exactly is? So, atom exactly is, if the smallest particle of a matter or a molecule is its atom. Okay, so there is some amount of mass of an atom. See, atom may or may not be capable of its single existence, means it needs some companion with it for its existence. Okay, so atoms, atomic mass can be calculated. Now, firstly, atom of oxygen, that is 1 upon, that is 16. Atomic mass of oxygen is 16, that was derived. And it was stated that all the elements can be derived from these one mass. So, it stated that all the elements are being multiplied with 1 upon 16 to get its mass. Okay, so to get its atomic mass. Okay, so and mass of the element are being multiplied to the atomic mass, that is 1/6 standard atomic mass, and then we can get the atomic mass of that particular atom in the that particular matter in the whole number. That's why it was stated that there was a need of some constant. Now if we see, then carbon and many other elements have lower atomic mass, then their mass would not come in the whole number. So the oxygen was cancelled and then carbon was stated as the fifth number, and then 1 upon 12th of the atomic mass was stated as the atomic mass constant. Okay, so this was what atomic mass was. Then existence of atom. Now how we can say that atom is existed? So if we take any molecule, then we will get two different kinds of atoms. Okay, whether they are of the same kind or whether they are of the different kinds. So we get a particular amount of particle inside the molecule, and that is known as its atom. Okay, then comes what is a molecule. Molecule is basically the combination of the two atoms or combination of two particles, because of which it is capable of its simpler it is capable of its own existence. Okay, it is it has all the properties of its solution, or we can say that it has all the components or properties of the substance which is itself in a part of. Okay, so molecules of elements. Now molecules of elements have the same kinds of atom. Okay, not number. Okay, so molecules of elements have same kind of atoms, and molecule of compounds have different kinds of atom but in the same proportion. Okay, so molecule of the compound has different kinds of atom but in same proportion. Okay, constant proportion, that is stated by law of constant proportion. Okay, so this is what molecule in element and molecule in compound is. Now we can say that molecule is the smallest indivisible particle of elements and compounds. Correct? Then comes ions. Now how is ion formed? So if due to valency, you can check out the structure of atom video, in that I have deeply explained about formation of ions. Okay, it must be in part 3 or part 4. Okay, then formation, what are basically ions? Ions are the positive and negative charges of a particular atom. So the positive charges are known as cations and the negative charges are known as anions. Okay, now how we can remember like this, that cations are positive and anions are negative? Now anions, negative stands for anions. So n stands for negative, so anions are negative, and just what is left, that is cation. So cations are positive. So this is how we can remember about ions. Now ions are positively or negatively charged particles, and because of they are formed only and only because of its valency. So to valence two electrons or valence two atoms, we need to shuffle its electrons. So this is how ions are formed and came into existence. Okay, so if you like the part 1 of atoms and molecules, and if you want to know more about the writing of chemical formulas and also how did the atoms got its name, then please stay tuned and like my video, comment down if there are any suggestions. Also share this video as much as possible, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get my latest updates. Thank you.